Hi, I'm James from GameFront, and welcome to Hot Off the Press Start, the weekly show that rounds up all the latest gaming news and delivers it quicker than the G-Man disappearing from the corner of your eye. Counter-Strike Global Offensive has officially surpassed Dota 2 as the most played game on Steam. CSGO has been gaining ground on Dota 2 for some time now, but officially it surpassed in December when CSGO had 767,000 peak users, compared to Dota 2's 628,000. It seems that this is actually due to a decline in Dota 2's numbers, a huge upsurge in CSGO's numbers. CSGO's numbers have been relatively consistent numbers. Dota 2 peaked in February of 2019, when it had 1 million concurrent players, but the numbers have steadily declined since then. With this recent huge Outlanders update, it also caused a big drop in players, no doubt due to the big overhaul in the game's mechanics. The data is thanks to SteamCharts.com, which shows concurrent player usage over time. What are your thoughts on Dota 2's Outlanders updates? Let us know in the comments down below. G-Man's first words since Half-Life 2 over 12 years ago has been revealed in a new cryptic trailer for Half-Life Alyx, which dropped during the new year. The new teaser confirms that Mike Shapiro, who voiced the character in previous games, is indeed returning to voice acting duties in Half-Life Alyx. Shapiro posted the teaser himself on Twitter on New Year's Eve. While Half-Life Alyx is a VR-only affair, it does have a AAA budget, and I'm very hopeful that this marks the start of a more mainstream return to the series. Either way, I'm excited to learn more lore and backstory to Half-Life 2 once Alyx drops later this year. It seems, despite ongoing legal battles between Ragnarok and Human Head Studios, which we reported on recently, Rune 2 will continue to be supported after all, with the first patch finally on its way. Rune 2, a game developed by Human Head Studios, was released back on the 12th of November. The day after its release, the company shut down, only to then reopen that very same day under a new name, Roundhouse Studios, and now under the ownership of Bethesda. It was all very strange, but Ragnarok Games, the publisher of the title, released a statement shortly after these events, reassuring the community that the game would still be supported, including all planned post-launch content, and also confirming that they had no idea what was going on, stating that they found out about this news when you did. Despite the promises, though, the developers refused to hand over the source code and even submitted illegal versions for review at the Epic Store. It seems now, though, that the progress must be being made because this to support the game during this time, as Ragnarok has now received the source code and the assets. Asus and Nvidia confirmed ahead of CES this week that they are developing a new monitor with a whopping 360Hz refresh rate and G-Sync support, designed specifically for esports performance. 360Hz is a huge number, effectively 360 frames per second being displayed, something that you'll find a struggle on even the beefiest of graphic cards. For esports games, though, every millisecond is the difference between winning and losing. It has the ability to display a new frame once every 2.8 milliseconds, which is pretty much amazing. And G-Sync will prevent the screen from tearing thanks to its adaptive refresh rate that will be synchronized with the GPU's output. The bad news is that it's only a 1080p monitor. Although, that kind of makes sense as you won't be hitting 360 frames per second on anything higher than that. Dota Underlord's popularity has dropped over 90% since launching, according to figures also obtained from Steam charts. Dota Underlords was an experiment by Valve on the Early Access platform, and was the first mobile game published by the company using the Source 2 engine. The game was an auto-battler, available both on PC and mobile devices. It had nearly 200,000 concurrent players, according to Steam charts, when it launched. But in recent weeks, it's been peaking at just 15,000 players. The more worrying fact is that this shows no signs of slowing, as popularity is on a consistent downslope, even with new updates being released. While the game has still mostly positive reviews on Steam, it seems that players just aren't sticking with the game anymore. And finally this week, footage has been released of a prequel to Portal that Valve was working on before the game was abandoned. Valve was working on a prequel to Portal based on a design experiment initiative launched shortly after the release of the Orange Box back in the day. Known as F-Stop, which is a play on the word aperture, I imagine, it was due to become a full-blown prequel to Portal. In the end, though, much like other Valve projects, it ended up fading away, never to see the light of day. That is, until now, as Lunch House Software, with Valve's permission, are promising to release a series on YouTube which will show off F-Stop and explain its history for the first time. We're not sure yet when these videos are going to be releasing, but there is going to be around 5 or 6 videos released in the series. And that's this week's gaming news. As always, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and click the bell icon to stay notified of any new videos from GameFront.